I guess you are watching this video because your computer is having this error. The code execution cannot proceed because xcd_audio1_6 is not found, or the program can start because xcd_audio1_6 is missing from your computer. It's a very common issue, and all you need to do is watch this video patiently and follow that method on your computer. Hello everyone, welcome to Track Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this error within 3 minutes. So let's get started. The first thing you need to do is open your favorite browser and search for xcd_audio1_6.dll. You can choose any result you want. In this case, I'll be choosing the first one. This is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. Here you can see a few download options based on the architecture and version. To know your architecture and version, click on Start and search for System Information. There you go. You can see mine is a 64-bit PC and I'm updated to the recent Windows updates. So, in this case, I'll be downloading the second one. I strongly recommend you to read this page. This can be effective as a backup process. As the download complete, hit open. You can see the DLL file in the downloaded zip. To move the DLL, first open this PC, new volume C, Windows, and find a folder named system32. This is the home of 32-bit DLL files. And click on the downloaded zip, drag the DLL, and drop. I have already done this, so it is asking me to replace. And click on continue to give administrator access. Before we go ahead, let's check. By typing the entire file name, you can see the file is placed in 32-bit folder. So the missing problem should be fixed for 32-bit users. Only if you are a 64-bit user, open this PC one more time, then new volume C, Windows, and find a folder name sys-wow64, which is the home of 64-bit DLL files. Then similarly, drag and drop. Basically, 64-bit users need to place the DLL file in both 32-bit folder and 64-bit folder. Check this one more time. Yeah, we can see the file is placed in 64-bit folder, so job is done. And finally, restart your computer. In extremely rare cases, if the error still occurs, you need to download and install latest Microsoft DirectX and install your program again, and that will surely fix it.
And that's all. If you follow me step by steps, you'll no longer have that problem left. Please let me know how you feel about this video, and do not forget to like and subscribe.